गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू लीगल मैटर्स बाय साई बाबू शंकर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीक ऑन ए केस लॉ डिसाइडेड बाय द कर्नाटक हाई कोर्ट रिगार्डिंग द फ्रीडम टू प्रोफेस, फ्रीडम टू प्रोपगेट रिलीजियन. सो दिस वॉज अपहेल्ड बाय द कर्नाटक हाई कोर्ट इन द केस ऑफ एस्थेरा लुई versus State of Karnataka in WP number 23423 by 2021 decided on 23-12-2021 by single judge S. Krishnan S. Dikshit of Karnataka High Court, wherein the High Court allowed a woman to conduct prayers in her house but with certain conditions, and also directed the police to videograph the same so that if any violations are there, so this may be cancelled. Right? Why this thing happened? First of all, we should know. Actually, the problem arises to October 26th. On October 26th, 2021, the SHO of Kunapura of Karnataka state, Kunapura PS, gave a notice to the petitioner Estela Luis not to conduct prayers in her house and not to hold any preachings in her house because it is alleged by the neighbors that corona is likely to spread because she is inviting so many persons from the other side. Some sounds are being heard, that means the volume is at a higher pitch and it is causing nuisance to the residents of the locality. Maybe the neighbors may be Hindus or somebody, we do not know. Basing on the allegation, the neighbors approached the police and said that there is continuous nuisance, particularly on Sundays, because of this woman, she is calling so many persons in the nearby locality and also from some other place. So many people are coming and they are conducting prayers with loud music, with loud amplifiers, due to which we are not getting sleep or we are not able to live peaceably. That is the allegation. Basing on that, they have given a notice to her and asked her not to conduct prayers in violation of the law. Then she approached the High Court. So the High Court heard both sides. Right, so she stated that Estela Luis, she stated that the impugned notice or the challenging notice or the notice given by the police is against to articles 14 right to equality, 15 discrimination, and 21 more than that to be precise, and article 25, that is right to profess and freedom of religion. And she cited so many case laws on secularism and also international laws regarding the professing of religion. Once he likes several case laws she cited, but anyway, now the point to be considered is number one, the spread of corona. After all, what is it? That house is a very simple house having an area of 2500 square feet where more than 50 persons cannot be settled, cannot take place in that also. So she is inviting her own friends because of the Christmas, coming Christmas. She has invited her friends. No doubt they have been telling her, they have been discussing about the Christianity and other things. And no doubt they are conducting prayers but closing the house. So when once you close the doors of the house, normally the sound may not be that audible and it may not be that disturbing to the others also. So this is the allegation. Now, the High Court, in its wisdom, considered the writ petition of the woman and allowed her, because the citizens of this country are free to profess, practice and propagate the religion or such religion, such faith and such belief they choose. So, this impugned notice or action is based, biased and prejudiced, and therefore, since it violates the secular fabric of the Constitution of India, is allowed but with certain restrictions. Here, she was cautioned that she should not engage any amplifiers, she should not put any sound. Number two, the gathering should be minimal, only relatives, only the so-called people who have got faith in that particular thing, and they should not use any amplifiers, and they should not cause any disturbance to the residents of the locality. And they have given a leverage to the police also. Yesterday I told you that videographing in that that scam, Peral scam case. So the MD is handed over to police custody, but the lawyer is allowed to be with him during the interrogation, and the interrogation should be videographed. Like that here also, the police can take a videograph of the entire situation, and if there is violation, definitely she will be liable to punishment. But anyway, so the main point for consideration in this case is that the secular fabric of the nation is held up by the Constitutional Court or by the High Court. So Karnataka High Court at last allowed the Christian woman to conduct prayers in her house, subject to the so-called reasonable restrictions by the police. Good judgment. Please read it and enrich your legal knowledge. Thank you very much.